Catherine from Catherine Learns Stuff. A few weeks ago, I made a video for you on how to calibrate your Cricut for print then cut using your desktop. While I was doing that, I also made a video on how to calibrate your Cricut for print then cut using your iPad. Now, since I use my iPad almost exclusively when I'm using my Cricut, I thought I would finally edit that video and get it up for you. So I want to apologize for all the spots where my head is in the way of the camera, but I wanted to walk you through this anyway. So let's jump in. So I quickly wanted to walk you through also how to calibrate your Cricut for print then cut on your iPad. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to select the back arrow here to go to our home screen. And we're going to select these three lines here on the left side of our screen too, and we're going to go to settings. And from our settings, we're going to go to print then cut settings, because that's what we're going to be working on. And we're going to be calibrating our machine. So you want to select the top item here, which says calibrate your machine. Now this is going to prompt us to print out a calibration sheet. I don't have one printed out yet, so I'm going to send it to printer, but if you have one, you can just use that one. So we're going to send this to our printer, and I'm just going to print this out with regular quality. So I've got a calibration sheet printed off here from my iPad, and I'm going to place this onto my cut mat and get ready to cut this out. So now that I have this cut placed on my cutting mat, I'm going to select next on my iPad. Okay, so now it's telling us to get this ready for our machine. So I'm going to pull my cutting mat into my machine. And you can either have the dial set to paper or card, like cardstock, depending on how you like to cut printer paper. I like that to use like cardstock because I find that sometimes the paper doesn't go far enough through. So I'm going to select the arrows, and then I'm going to follow the prompts. And now I'm going to select the flashing C. Okay, so again, this has cut out our square here. I'm going to try to get a good angle on this. And we're going to inspect this to see if this has cut all the way through. So it's a bit difficult to see. So I'm not going to take my cutting mat out, but I am going to pull my sheet up here so that I can see how it could cut through. And it cut all the way through, it looks like, in all the spots. And it's already coming out here. But I'm going to note, you're going to notice, though, even on this piece here that's cut out, that it's not totally centered. Yes, it's got the black lines a little bit visible here, but there's more black here visible on the outline. So it's not totally perfect. So I'm not happy with that, because I want to make sure that when I'm cutting print then cuts, it's cutting perfectly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the no, it did not do the good job that I wanted it to, and we're going to do some more calibrations on this, because we want to have nice cutout lines. Okay, so now again it's going to prompt us to ask us which number here and which letter here is the most lined up accurately on the design here. So we're going to zoom in a little bit and we're going to review here. We're going to look across the edges here, and this one here looks like number 11 is good because 12 and 10 are just a little bit off. And this way here, oh, this is going to be tricky because I and J again looking pretty good, but not I'm going to go with J this time. So we're going to go 11 and J on our machine here. So we're going to pick line 11 and then J, and we're going to select next. So it's going to ask us to unload our machine, and we're going to print out another copy of our calibration sheet. Okay, so we've got our calibration sheet ready here. We're going to put it onto our cutting mat again. And we're going to select next on our calibration page, and we've got our thing, our print off ready to go, and we're going to put it back into our machine, and we're going to see how it cuts this time. All right, so again, it's cut it out here, and we're gonna take a quick peek. It's really hard to tell with where it's cut through, so I'm just going to, again, pull my sheet up here, and now you'll notice that I've got a black outline on the whole box, and I've still got a black outline left here. So I think that's pretty good. So I'm gonna give it a yes, we are good with this, and we're going to proceed to the next step of this calibration. Okay, so now again, we're gonna just zoom in here. Again, it's cut the lines across the numbers and the letters, and we're gonna look again to see which one is the best in the numbers and the best in the letters. So hopefully my head doesn't get in the way, but I think this is gonna be a number 9 this time. That's the best fit here. And here, I think it's going to be a K. So we're gonna select 9 and K in our options menu here. And we're going to select next. Okay, and now, so it's cut out this box here. And again, it's really hard to see if it's cut it out well or not. So what we're going to do is we're going to pull this up, leaving everything on our mat. So you'll notice here, get this off, that this actually has a black outline all the way around it. And it's got a black outline all the way here. So this is cut out very nicely. So I'm very happy with this, and I'm going to select yes. But if you were not, if it was off again, you could select no and continue the calibration process. And that's it. And now our printer and our Cricut are calibrated to our iPads, and we're ready to do some print then cuts. And there you have it. You've successfully calibrated your print then cut for your printer and your Cricut using your iPad. The one thing I wanted to point out is when you're printing and cutting and you have something calibrated, you want to make sure that that's the main thing that you're using. So I primarily use my iPad, so my Cricut is calibrated to my iPad. If you are using a desktop and then you want to switch to an iPad, you need to make sure to recalibrate your instruments again. If you don't, you might end up having your cut lines off, and we don't really like that. So that's just something to keep in mind. If you're using your iPad, calibrate to your iPad. If you're using to your desktop, calibrate to your desktop, and then just use that. And then calibrate in between if needed. So that's it for now. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Let me know if you have any questions or comments in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching, and happy crafting. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.